Hi everyone, Ashley here and welcome to another video on my YouTube channel. Today I have another speed carving video for you showing how to make these fun paper pieced hearts with leftover scraps of pattern paper. And I turned these into thank you cards, and I made a set of thank you cards that are all the same. So without further ado, let's get into it. I'm starting by prepping the backgrounds. So I took a heart die and I just traced around it with some pencil. And then I'm going in with my tape runner and just filling in those hearts with tape as much as I can. It's okay if you have some white space, it really doesn't matter as long as there's enough tape there to hold down those pieces of paper. So then I'm going in with just strips of paper that I cut out from all of my scraps of pattern paper, and I just made sure to cut enough different shades out that I can build up a rainbow. And I cut them at slightly varying widths so that it just adds a little bit of interest to the pattern. Once I had put a few on, I made sure to take my heart die and go in and trace around the edge of one of the corners of the heart, just to make sure that I would know where to put that heart to eventually die cut these pieces out later once all the pieces are stuck on. So then I continue just continuing to build the pattern by adding strips of color, going from red all the way to the end of the rainbow at purple at the bottom. And I just put them one by one and stuck them down. And since we already put the tape runner, they just stick right down onto that tape, which is really nice. So it makes it super fast. Off camera, I went ahead and die cut those hearts out. And again, I just sort of followed where I had traced that die and they cut it perfectly. I then cut out three white banners just using some white cardstock and a Lanvin banner die. And I'm just stamping out the word thanks on using some black ink onto these banners. And when I have odd shapes like this, I like to hold them down with my magnets to make sure they really stay in place in my Mini Misti as I stamp them. And then you can stamp the next piece by just sort of slotting it under where you had just stamped, and then you don't even have to move the stamp in the Mini Misti, which is nice. So to build out these cards, I'm just adhering those hearts down onto white card bases right in the middle. And the good thing about making multiple cards like this is that you can save time by sort of doing the same step over and over. So rather than going one card at a time, I just do one step at a time. So I glue down all three hearts at once. And then I'm gonna stamp out a couple extra words onto each card base all at once. So I'm stamping out can't say on the top left and enough on the bottom so that the overall sentiment will read can't say thanks enough. So I sort of curved the can't say up at the top so that it sort of follows the curve of the heart. And then I kept enough straight at the bottom, again, kind of angling it to follow the curve of the heart. And then once I've done that for one, I can just bring in the next card base, make sure that it's lined up perfectly by sort of flipping the Mini Misti back and forth and making sure that it's gonna stamp out exactly where I want it, and then stamping that down. So this way you can do all three cards, you can stamp them all at once and not have to sort of go back and forth between steps, which actually makes the process go a lot faster. So next, I knew I wanted to adhere these panels onto some foam so that they'd be a little bit elevated from the card base. So I went ahead and prepped three pieces of fun foam that are slightly smaller than that card front panel, and I adhered double-sided tape to both sides of all the foam. Then I can take the double-sided tape, a release paper off, and stick those foam pieces down to card bases, and then stick the card panels onto them. And this just creates a nice level of elevation up from the card for those card panels. The final step of these cards is to adhere those thanks banners right into the middle, and again I used foam for these two to give them a little pop of extra dimension from the front of the card panel. And once this step is done, the cards are done. So these are actually super simple cards to make, even though they do look really intricate and detailed because of all of that lovely pattern paper. But again, they're just made from scraps, so you don't even have to cut out extra pieces, which is great. So that is all three cards in the set for today. So I hope that you enjoyed watching this super quick video, and I hope this inspires you to go back to your card scraps and use them up. This is a great way to do it. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!